Hey guys, and welcome back to another Technology Guru video. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to live stream from your mobile device. So this is going to work for both iPhone and Android devices and any other mobile device that you may be using. It's going to be working for phones and tablets and whatever it may be. So I've done a video on how to live stream on YouTube from your desktop client using OBS. If you're going to want to know how to do that, click the little YouTube card in the upper part of this here video. But today we're going to be focusing more on the mobile side of things. So what you're going to want to do is go ahead and open up your YouTube app. Then what you're going to want to see there in the upper portion of your YouTube screen there, you're going to see the little record button. Used to be this little camera icon here was just for recording and it wasn't for going live. But now if you tap on it, you're going to see another option there with the little circle and the little outline lines on the outside of it. It's going to say go live. Click on the go live button or tap it there, and then you're going to see me in my beautiful face here early in the morning, right? One other pro tip, by the way, is to slide up on your iPhone or find however you can do this on your device and turn airplane mode on. Make sure Wi-Fi is connected, so make sure your Wi-Fi is on and airplane mode is on as well. That way you're not going to get any phone calls or distractions during your wonderful live stream. Now let's go to settings, the little gear icon in the upper right-hand side of the screen. This is going to allow you to choose a few different settings. You're going to have the tab there that says allow chat. If you want to allow chat, just make that go to the right. If you want to enable age restriction, if it's going to be something with profanity or something that people under the age of 18 shouldn't be viewing, go ahead and enable age restriction there. Also, you have an option to say this video contains a paid promotion. Click that little guy there. Then you can also enable monetization by tapping the last one there at the very bottom of the screen. The top thing there is going to be your description. As you can see, this is my description that I have already put into YouTube natively. Basically, this is what I put on the Creative Studio. Every video that I upload will have a lot of this generic stuff on there. So that's what you're seeing in my description. Now, if you're satisfied with all of this information, go back to where you see this option here by tapping on the left arrow in the upper left-hand side of the screen. Then what you're going to want to do is tap on the option that says create a title. So go ahead and title your video here. And then once you get a title, you're going to see the big red next button come available to you there. Something that a lot of creators are doing now is they're going to their emojis and they're using this little red dot here that looks like a record button, which I think is fairly clever. So if you want to do that, navigate to your emojis on your keyboard and then scroll all the way to the right and you're going to see a little red record button there. But obviously I'm not going to do that now. If you wanted to, you could click the drop down menu next to the word that says public, and that's going to allow you to choose whether or not you want this live stream to be public or unlisted, which I'm not sure why you would want to do that. But if you do, that option is available for you. Once you're done with your title, you then can click the red next button. Now, if you wanted to, you could turn your camera around to where it's not looking at you like the selfie camera. You can click the little rotating arrows in the upper right-hand side of the screen, and now you can see my camera that's going to be showing you what I'm looking at. But I'm going to go ahead, and for the most part, you're probably going to want it to be pointed at you in your direction. Then click the red next button there. It's then going to give you the options to, hey, smile for a thumbnail. That's hideous. Let's retake it. Go ahead and click the retake button right there. Smile for the camera. Just like that right there. If you're satisfied with your thumbnail, you can actually go and click the share button just like this here. And a bunch of other platforms are going to come available to you. And you can swipe left or right and choose whether or not you want to copy the link to share that link. Or if you want to share on Facebook or Gmail or email, whatever you want to do, you can share that from that share button. Obviously, if you want to retake your thumbnail, click the retake button there. But if you are satisfied with everything, you're ready to go. And remember, you must obviously, I thought this was something that people would already know, but make sure that you are logged into your YouTube channel that you want to stream from. And then when you're good to go, click the go live button. And my friends, you will be live as live can be. It will take maybe 5 to 10 seconds to load. And then once you're live, you're going to see a few different options here. What's up, guys? I'm live. You're going to see how long you've been live in the upper left-hand corner. You are also going to be seeing how many people have joined you in the upper left-hand corner. And then then if anyone has liked the video, you will also see that by the thumbs up icon you see right above me right here. Also, you can click the finish button when you're done. Also, you have the little rotate camera in the lower left-hand corner. You have the chat room, which will be the little chat icon here where you can see all of the messages coming through. And then you also have the edit or the little magic wand button there that will actually show you, and it will allow you to change your different camera styles, glamour shots, and you can do dance parties and a bunch of wild stuff, right? So again, that is how you do it within the mobile device. When you're done, click the finish button in the upper right-hand corner. It'll say, are you sure you're done streaming? Hit the end button there. It will wrap everything up with a little circle. It will say finished. It'll let you know how long your live stream went for, what the duration was, the average watch time for the people who came, the peak co-concurrent viewers, so the peak of which how many people were watching your stream, new subscribers you got from the screen, from the stream, and that's about it. So that is how you live stream from the mobile device over on YouTube. I really hope you guys got a lot of value from this video. If you did, go ahead and let me know by liking the video, sharing the video, and subscribing for more great content just like this. And if you're interested in growing your YouTube channel, listen to our podcast every Wednesday, YouTube Creators Hub, where I interview creators just like you and talk with them about their YouTube strategy. Guys, until next time, keep pressing that record button. I'll talk to you later.